So in this lecture, we are going to study electromagnetic wave propagation and good conductors, and we are going to solve few problems related to the EM waves in different media. Before we start, let us revise what we have studied in the previous lecture. So in the previous lecture, we defined the quantity tan theta. We call this tan theta as loss tangent. Loss tangent defines whether a given media is a good conductor or good dielectric. If loss tangent is very much less than 1, means loss tangent is small, then the medium is said to be good dielectric. If loss tangent is large, means very much greater than 1, the medium acts like a good conductor. Where loss tangent tan theta is equal to sigma by omega epsilon. So you can write tan theta very much less than 1 means sigma is very much less than omega epsilon is the condition. Tan theta very much greater than 1 means sigma is very much greater than omega epsilon is the condition for a medium to be a good dielectric or good conductor. So using these conditions, we have derived the expressions for electric field and magnetic field inside a good dielectric and a free space. So you got the expression for a good dielectric. We also call a good dielectric medium as lossless medium. So you obtain the expression for the electric field for a good dielectric as E naught cos of omega t minus beta z ax bar, and h bar of z comma t is equal to E naught by mod neta into cos of omega t minus beta z ay bar. So it is observed that the electric field intensity and magnetic field intensity will vary cosinusoidally along the z axis and having only components x and y respectively. So if you observe the amplitude part of the cosinusoidal signal, it maintains a constant amplitude with a distance, means the amplitude of the cosinusoidal signal does not vary with a distance. Means as the wave propagates along the z direction, the amplitude of the cosinusoidal signal, means the electric field, will maintain a constant amplitude at E naught and minus E naught. Means as the wave is propagating along the z direction, it is not getting attenuated. Since it is not getting attenuated, it is not losing any power. Means the medium through which it is passing is a lossless medium. So we call this medium as a lossless medium. Hence, a good dielectric medium is also called as lossless medium. Means that a good dielectric, means a good insulator, will support the electromagnetic wave to propagate through it. The only difference for air interface is if you consider the medium to be free space. The only difference you will get is in place of mod neta, you will get neta naught, which is nothing but the intrinsic impedance of the air. You will get the value equal to 120 pi or 377 ohms. So you will get the same expression for free space also. Only the difference is in place of mod neta, you will get this. For good dielectric, mod neta is equal to root over of mu by epsilon. So for free space, for good dielectric, neta is mod mu by epsilon. For free space, it is neta naught, which is equal to 120 pi or 377 ohms. Means free space is also a lossless medium, means which allows the electromagnetic wave to propagate through the space without attenuating it. Next, we define transverse electromagnetic wave. So if the electric field and the magnetic field does not have components along the direction of propagation of the wave, then we call them as transverse electromagnetic waves. For example, in this assumption, we made electric field has x components and magnetic field has y component, but the wave is propagating along z components. So E electric field has only x component and magnetic field has only y component, but the wave is traveling along the z axis. Means it, the electric field does not have a component along z axis, also the magnetic field does not have any component along z axis. Means this type of wave is called as transverse electromagnetic wave. Electric field can also have components along y axis, and magnetic field can also have components along both x axis and y axis. If the wave is traveling along z axis and the electric field has components along x and y, magnetic field also have components along x and y. So if you observe this type of wave is also called as transverse electromagnetic wave, because the wave is propagating along z axis, it does not have components along z axis. Hence the wave can be called as transverse electromagnetic wave. So you can say it another way: if the electromagnetic wave does not have components along the direction of propagation, we call it as a transverse electromagnetic wave. Or you can also say, if the electromagnetic wave have components in a plane transversal to the direction of propagation, then also it is called as transverse electromagnetic. So any arbitrary direction if the wave is propagating, If the electric field and magnetic field are only in the plane perpendicular to the direction of propagation, so electric may be, field may be oriented like this, the corresponding magnetic field will be perpendicular to it. So this is electric field and this is magnet. But these two, electric field and magnetic fields, are having components only in the plane perpendicular to the direction of propagation. Then this type of wave is called TEM. If it has component also along the direction of propagation, then these are not TEM waves. Next, we define plane wave. Plane wave means if the wave is propagating along a particular direction. So if we observe the transversal plane, means the plane which is perpendicular to the direction of propagation. So in a plane which is perpendicular to the direction of propagation, and if this plane is is an infinite sheet, means it will extend from infinite to minus infinite along this direction. Also, it will extend from infinite to minus infinite along this direction. Means on an infinite sheet, which is transversal to the direction of propagation of the wave, if the electric field is maintained constant throughout this sheet up to infinite, and if the magnetic field corresponding to this electric field will be perpendicular to it, if this also maintained constant throughout the plane, means from infinite to minus infinite, then such waves are called as uniform plane waves or plane waves. Uniform plane waves are plane waves. Means if the electric field and magnetic field have constant magnitude throughout the transversal plane, which is of infinite length, then we call such waves as uniform plane waves. But if the electric field is having constant magnitude throughout the transversal plane, then it will have infinite power. So practically infinite power is not possible. Hence uniform plane waves are only ideal waves. Practically these are not possible. Because as the electric field, if you consider in the transversal plane, after some distance, the field may go to zero. It can't maintain constant amplitude for infinite distance. So uniform plane waves are ideal waves. For a uniform plane wave, the power, if you calculate, it will become infinite, which is not practically possible. So in the previous lecture, we have concluded here. Now we will continue our derivation of electric fields and magnetic fields inside a good conductor. So the condition you have to consider is, for a good conductor, sigma is very much greater than epsilon naught, or sigma almost tend to infinite. So sigma conductivity of the medium tend to infinite for a good conductor. So we start our analysis of electromagnetic wave propagation inside a good The characteristics of a good conductor is, sigma is very much greater than omega epsilon, implies that sigma by omega epsilon almost tend to infinite. Because the conductivity of a perfect or good conductor, sigma will be equal to infinite. So sigma by omega epsilon approaches to infinite, means sigma is approximately approaches to infinite in a very good conductor, perfect conductor. And permittivity is equal to epsilon naught, mu is equal to mu naught into mu r. So these are the characteristics of a good conductor. Now we will solve for the propagation constant, phase constant, attenuation constant, intrinsic impedance, velocity, wavelength. All this we have to again derive for good conductor also. Then we will substitute these constants in the electric field and magnetic field equations, which we have got for lossy dielectric medium. Then we will get the electromagnetic wave propagation inside a good conductor. So let us start with propagation constant. So you got gamma square for a lossless dielectric medium as j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon. So gamma square is equal to j omega mu. If I take sigma common, I will get it as 1 plus j omega epsilon divided by sigma. Since sigma is tending to infinite, if sigma tends to infinite, omega epsilon by sigma tends to 0, because denominator tending to infinite, since sigma tends to infinite. So this term will become 1. So gamma square is equal to j omega mu sigma. From this you can write gamma is equal to root over of j omega mu sigma. Now let us derive the expressions for phase constant and attenuation constant. Attenuation constant alpha and phase constant beta. So you already know that propagation constant gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta. You can write gamma square is equal to alpha plus j beta whole square, which is equal to alpha square plus j beta whole square plus 2 into alpha into j beta, which can be written as gamma square minus beta square plus 2 j into 2 alpha beta. But you got gamma square is equal to j omega mu sigma. So let us compare this with this. So you will get, you got gamma square is equal to j omega mu sigma. Compare these two. So gamma square has only imaginary part. means the real part, which is equal to alpha square minus beta square, is equal to 0, and the imaginary part 2 alpha beta is equal to omega mu sigma. So real gamma square has real part here is equal to 0, so 0 is equal to alpha square minus beta square, imaginary part is omega mu sigma, here the imaginary part is 2 alpha beta, so we compared these two. So from this you can write alpha square is equal to beta square, or alpha is equal to beta. Similarly here you got alpha is equal to beta, now you substitute in place of beta, you substitute alpha, you will get 2 into alpha into beta is equal to alpha, so alpha into alpha is alpha square is equal to omega mu sigma, or you can write alpha is equal to omega mu sigma by 2 under root. So in this way we derive the attenuation constant alpha, but we have the condition alpha is equal to beta, means the attenuation constant alpha is equal to root over of omega mu sigma divided by 2, which is equal to the phase constant, which is also equal to omega mu sigma divided by 2. So you can write alpha is equal to beta is equal to root over of omega mu sigma divided by 2. You can further simplify this as root over of omega can be written as 2 pi f mu sigma divided by 2, which is equal to root over of pi f mu sigma. So you got the final expressions for attenuation constant. So for a good conductor, attenuation constant and phase constant are equal, and alpha is equal to beta is equal to root over of pi f mu sigma. Now let us derive the expression for intrinsic impedance. So the general expression for intrinsic impedance neta is j omega mu by gamma. So for a good conductor you got gamma is equal to root over of j omega mu sigma. So neta is equal to j omega mu divided by root over of j omega mu sigma. It can be simplified as, so you can write this as j omega mu whole square divided by j omega mu sigma under root. So j omega mu and this will get cancelled, so you will get it as root over of j omega mu by sigma. So neta can be represented in terms of magnitude part and angle part as mod neta and angle theta neta. Mod neta can be determined as modulus of root over of j omega mu by sigma, which can be written as root over of in the numerator real part is 0, 0 square plus omega mu whole square divided by denominator sigma square plus there is no imaginary part here 0 square. So you will get the answer root over of omega mu whole square under root. So you will get omega mu divided by sigma square under root, so sigma. So mod neta is equal to root omega mu by sigma. Let us calculate angle theta neta. Theta neta is equal to angle of this, angle of root over of j omega mu by sigma. So you can write the numerator part angle is half tan inverse imaginary part by real part. Imaginary part is omega mu, real part is 0. Denominator angle is minus half, we are writing because it is under root. So half tan inverse imaginary part is not there, 0 divided by real part sigma. So here you will get half tan inverse infinite. Tan inverse infinite is 90 degrees, means pi by 2. Minus half tan inverse 0 is 0. So this is equal to pi by 4. So theta neta is equal to pi by 4. So neta can be represented as magnitude part as root over of omega mu by sigma and angle as 45 degrees. Pi by 4 is equal to 45 degrees. So now let us determine wavelength. Wavelength lambda is related to beta as 2 pi by beta. So you got beta is equal to beta and alpha are same for a good conductor, you got it as omega mu sigma by 2. You can also write it as 2 pi by root over of pi f mu sigma, which can be further simplified as root over of 2 pi divided by f mu sigma in terms of f. Or otherwise, you can just consider lambda is equal to 2 pi by beta and beta is equal to root over of omega mu sigma divided by 2. Similarly, you can define the velocity. Velocity u is equal to frequency into wavelength. Frequency f. Wavelength is equal to 2 pi by beta, means which is equal to omega by beta. Again, if you substitute for omega beta, you will get it as beta is equal to root over of omega mu sigma divided by 2. Or otherwise, you can write it as 2 omega divided by mu sigma. So this is the velocity of wave propagation inside a good conductor. So if you observe, the velocity is a function of frequency. So different frequencies will travel with different velocity inside a conductor. We call this type of medium as dispersive medium. Let us determine the electric field intensity and magnetic field intensity inside a good conductor. We have, for a lossy dielectric medium, the electric field intensity as a function of z and time is E naught e power minus alpha z cos of omega t minus beta z ax bar, and h bar of z comma t is equal to h naught e power minus alpha z cos of omega t minus beta z minus theta and eta. Oh, no, this is A by bar, which can be represented in terms of electric field intensity magnitude E0 as E0 mod eta e power minus alpha z cos of omega t minus beta z minus theta and eta A by bar. So if you observe here, for a good conductor, alpha is not equal to 0. So there is no need of substituting for alpha here. So alpha is equal to beta is equal to, you got for a good conductor, alpha is equal to beta is equal to root over of omega mu sigma divided by 2. So here in place of alpha, you have to substitute this, and beta also you have to substitute this. There is no change in the electric field intensity. If you observe the magnetic field intensity, H0 is equal to e power, H bar is equal to H0 e power minus alpha z cos of omega t minus beta z A by bar. So you can write in terms of E0 as H0 is equal to E0 by mod eta e power minus alpha z cos of omega t minus beta z minus theta eta. But you got theta eta for a good conductor equal to 45 degrees. So in place of theta eta, you have to substitute 45 degrees. So you will get the magnetic field intensity H bar of z comma t is equal to E0 by mod eta. Mod eta is equal to root over of omega mu by sigma. Root over of omega mu by sigma e power minus alpha z cos of omega t minus beta z minus 45 degrees A by bar. So we can conclude that the electric field intensity and magnetic field intensity inside a conducting medium is going to get attenuated with distance. So the amplitude of the signal or the electric field intensity gets attenuated along the direction of propagation through the conducting medium. So since it is getting attenuated, it loses its power as it propagates. Means a good conductor can hardly support the electromagnetic wave to propagate through it. Means it does not allow the electromagnetic wave to penetrate through the conducting medium. So this implies that electric field and magnetic field cannot propagate deep into a conducting medium. Also, there is a phase difference between electric field intensity and magnetic field intensity. The phase difference is given by 45 degrees. So the phase difference between electric field intensity and magnetic field intensity is 45 degrees. So H bar lags E bar by 45 degrees. So you can conclude that the electric field and the magnetic field can hardly propagate through a good conductor. Means the electromagnetic wave cannot penetrate through the good conductor. Next, electric field and magnetic field are out of phase by 45 degrees. Means H bar lags E bar by 45 degrees in a good conductor. So you got the electric field intensity inside a good conductor. E bar is equal to E0 e power minus alpha z cos of omega t minus beta z ax bar. And H bar is equal to E0 by root over of omega mu by sigma e power minus alpha z cos of omega t minus beta z minus 45 degrees A by bar. So you'll observe that the amplitude of the electric field and magnetic field exponentially decreases by a factor of e power minus alpha z. So amplitude gets attenuated by a factor of e power minus alpha z. This implies that the electromagnetic wave can hardly propagate through a good conductor. So to measure how much depth the electromagnetic wave can propagate through any given media, we will define a quantity called as skin depth. Skin depth is represented by delta. So skin depth measure the depth to which an electromagnetic wave can penetrate the medium. So how much depth an electromagnetic wave can effectively penetrate through a medium, we call it as skin depth. So this depth will be very less for a conductor. The delta will be very small for a conductor because electromagnetic wave is getting drastically attenuated by a factor of e power minus alpha z, and alpha has a value of alpha and beta will have the same value, and alpha has a value for a good conductor to be root over of omega mu sigma divided by 2. So as the conductivity of the material and frequency of the electromagnetic wave increases, alpha will increase, attenuation factor, attenuation constant will increase as frequency of the electromagnetic wave as well as the conductivity of the conductor increase. The more the material is a good conductor, the less the electromagnetic wave can penetrate through it. Means the effective distance through which electromagnetic wave, the effective distance by which electromagnetic wave can penetrate through the conductor goes on decreases as the conductivity of the material increases. So a very perfect good conductor does not allow the electromagnetic wave. So if you consider, so this has a conductor medium. So if the electromagnetic wave, if it is air, so if the electromagnetic wave is propagating like this, so the wave, when it touches the conductor surface, it does not penetrate into the conductor, because when it gets in touch with the conducting medium, it will get attenuated. Means the depth through which the electromagnetic wave propagates is given by, effective depth is given by delta, which will be very small for a conductor, almost negligible. So as the conductivity goes on increases, the skin depth goes on decreases. So as conductivity goes on increases for a conductor, its skin depth goes on decreases. So perfect the conductor, the lesser the skin depth. Means the electromagnetic wave cannot penetrate as the conductivity of the material increases. So now we will calculate the skin depth for any given medium. So skin depth is a measure of the depth to which an EM wave can penetrate the medium. So skin depth is a measure of the depth to which an electromagnetic wave can penetrate through the medium. Means the effective distance electromagnetic wave can travel through the given media is called as skin depth. So if you observe the electric field intensity and magnetic field intensity, if you observe the amplitude of the signal, the amplitude of the signal exponentially decays with distance. So if you plot on x axis the distance z and on y axis the amplitude of the signal, which is equal to e naught e power minus alpha z, when z equal to 0, e naught into e power minus alpha z is equal to e naught into e power 0 means e naught. So at z equal to 0 its amplitude is e naught. As z increases the signal will get attenuated exponentially. So this envelope is nothing but e naught e power minus alpha z. So skin depth is defined as the distance over which the amplitude of the signal will decrease by 37% of its initial value. 37% of its initial value means it will become e naught into e power minus 1. If you calculate e naught into e power minus 1, it will be equal to 0.37 into e naught. Means after traveling a distance of skin depth, which is delta meters, the amplitude of the electromagnetic wave, which is given by e naught e power minus alpha z, decreases from its initial value. Initial value is at z equal to 0, which is equal to e naught. It will decrease to 0.37 times e naught, which is nothing but 37% of the initial value. Hence this distance delta is called as skin depth of the medium. So if you want to know after traveling a distance of delta meters, what is the amplitude of the electric field? Electric field is given by e naught e power minus alpha z cos of omega t minus beta z ax bar. After traveling a distance of delta, the amplitude of the signal, will become e naught e power minus alpha z at z equal to what? Delta meters. Means at z equal to delta meters, the amplitude will become e naught e power minus alpha. In place of z, I have to substitute delta. So this is the amplitude of the signal after traveling a distance of delta meters. But if you observe, after traveling a distance of delta meters, which we call it as skin depth, the amplitude will decrease by how much percentage? 0.37%. Means it will become equal to 0.37 into, so this will become equal to 0.37 into e naught. Or you can also say it is equal to e naught into e power minus 1. So e naught into e power minus alpha delta is equal to e naught into e power minus 1. You can write e naught into e power minus alpha delta is equal to e naught into e power minus 1. So if you compare these two, so you will get it as alpha into delta is equal to 1, or delta, which is equal to skin depth, is equal to 1 by alpha. So skin depth delta is reciprocal of the attenuation constant. So as the attenuation constant increases for a given media, the skin depth goes on decreases. If you observe, I said the attenuation constant goes on increases with increase of the conductivity of the material. So alpha increases as sigma increases. Conductivity of the material increases means attenuation constant increases. If attenuation constant increases, skin depth will decrease. So as attenuation constant increases, skin depth will decrease. Means if the conductivity of the material increases, its attenuation goes on increases. If attenuation goes on increases, skin depth will goes on decrease. Means the more the conductor is perfect, the lesser the electromagnetic wave can penetrate through it. So the effective distance electromagnetic wave can penetrate through a given media is defined as skin depth. So if the wave travels by a distance equal to skin depth, its amplitude will decrease from its initial value to 37% of its initial value. We obtain skin depth delta. Delta is equal to 1 by alpha. So if you consider the medium to be partial conducting, conducting means the material more act like an insulator, means dielectric. So if it is a good dielectric medium, means partially conducting medium, alpha for a good dielectric medium is equal to 0. Attenuation constant is almost equal to 0 for a good dielectric, or if you consider free space. Then the skin depth is equal to 1 by alpha, which is equal to 1 by 0, which tends to infinite. Means the skin depth is considerably large for a for a good dielectric or free space. We can also call it as partially conducting medium. But if you consider the skin depth for a good conductor, it will be very much less. So we should more concentrate on skin depth calculation for a good conductor. So if you consider a good conductor, for a good conductor you got attenuation constant alpha is equal to beta is equal to root over of omega mu sigma divided by 2. After further simplification you got it as pi f mu sigma alpha. So from this you can obtain the skin depth for a good conductor as delta is equal to 1 by alpha, which is equal to 1 by root over of pi f mu sigma. Means the depth of penetration through a good conductor delta is inversely proportional to the conductivity of the material as well as frequency of the material. Frequency as well as conductivity. So if you see, as the frequency of the electromagnetic wave increases or the conductivity of the medium increases, the skin depth will decrease. Means the electromagnetic wave can hardly propagate through a good conductor. Now let us find the relation between the intrinsic impedance of a conductor to the skin depth of the conductor. So you got the skin depth of a conductor delta is equal to 1 by attenuation constant alpha, which is equal to 1 by root over of pi f mu sigma. Also you obtain the intrinsic impedance for a good conductor. If you represent eta in terms of magnitude part and angle part, it is equal to root over of omega mu by sigma angle 45 degrees. So the magnitude is omega mu by sigma and angle is 45 degrees. Now we have to bring this eta in terms of delta. So you can write the magnitude part as 2 pi f omega is equal to 2 pi f mu divided by sigma angle 45 degrees, which can be further simplified as, so if I multiply numerator and denominator with sigma, I will get 2 pi f mu sigma divided by sigma square under root into angle 45 degrees. So if I separate out 2 by sigma square into root over of pi f mu sigma angle 45 degrees. From this you can write root over of pi f mu sigma is equal to 1 by delta. So now you can write this as root 2 divided by root over of sigma square is equal to just sigma into root over of pi f mu sigma is equal to 1 by delta angle 45 degrees. So you can write this as root 2 by sigma delta angle 45 degrees. The other way you can also represent this as, this is the magnitude and this is the angle. You can write this as root 2 by sigma delta. The angle can be represented as e power j 45 degrees. So root 2 by sigma delta e power j 45 degrees is nothing but cos 45 plus j sin 45. Means root 2 by sigma delta cos 45 is 1 by root 2 plus j by root 2 sin 45. So you can write this as root 2 by sigma delta into 1 by root 2 plus j root 2 by root 2. Or you can write root 2 by sigma delta into j by root 2. So root 2 root 2 gets cancelled, you will get 1 by sigma delta plus j by sigma delta. So eta, which is the intrinsic impedance of the conductor, has a real part equal to 1 by sigma delta and imaginary part is also equal to 1 by sigma delta. This is in rectangular form, this is in polar form, a polar form of eta, magnitude and angle. This is the rectangular form, real part and imaginary part. So this is the relation between eta and intrinsic impedance and delta, which is skin depth. So if we calculate the skin depth for a copper conductor, so for a copper conductor, if you calculate the skin depth at frequency, electromagnetic wave frequency equal to 10 hertz, the depth it can penetrate, the electromagnetic wave can penetrate up to 20.8 millimeters only. When the frequency increases, the skin depth further decreases. Means, for example, if the frequency is 500 hertz, the skin depth will become equal to 2.99 millimeters. So you have the relation delta is equal to 1 by root over of pi f mu sigma. So as the frequency of operation of the electromagnetic wave increases, for a given conductivity sigma, delta goes on decreases. So as f increases, delta goes on decreases. So if you observe at a frequency of 10 to the power 10 hertz, means 10 gigahertz, the skin depth will become equal to 6.6 into 10 to the power minus 4 millimeters, very very less. So as the frequency of operation increases, the skin depth goes on decreasing. So if we consider any conducting material of length L and it has a radius of A, L meters and A meters, consider the current or fields through this type of conductor. So the field or the currents will get concentrated over a small layer of this conductor of thickness equal to delta. Means all electromagnetic wave can penetrate only up to a depth of delta. So most of the electric fields or magnetic fields concentrate only on the outer surface of the conductor, because the skin depth of the conductor is very small. Means if you are passing a current equal to 10 to the power 10 hertz, means 10 gigahertz, the electric field and the magnetic field will get concentrated over only this much width. 6.6 into 10 to the power minus 4 means it will concentrate over a distance of 0.0006. So this much width the electric field or magnetic field will be confined. We also called this thickness is very small. We also called this layer on which the electric field is concentrating as skin. So since the electric field intensity is concentrated on a very thin layer, which is called as skin of the conductor, this phenomena is called as skin effect. Means the phenomena whereby field intensity in a conductor rapidly decreases is known as skin effect. So if you observe, the electric field will rapidly decrease as you go deeper into the conductor. So it will mostly concentrate on only the outer surface of the conductor, which we call it as skin. This is called as skin effect, means the phenomenon by which the fields or field intensity in a conductor rapidly decreases is known as a skin effect. This happens only inside a conductor. So the electric field intensity gets only concentrated on the outer layer, which is very small. We call this phenomenon as a skin effect. So this skin effect is very much advantageous in many applications. So if you are passing AC currents to this material, most of the fields will get concentrated only on the outer layer of the material. Means if you take a conductor, which is a solid conductor, let us consider it is made of silver. Even though you take a solid conductor, the most of the signal will get concentrated only on the outer layer of the conductor. So it does not penetrate deep into this conductor. So even though it is a solid conductor, there is no difference between a conductor of this much thickness and a solid conductor. So if you consider a hollow conductor of this much thickness, the performance of this type of conductor made of silver will be same if you consider a silver conductor which is solid, which is not hollow. Means that the difference in performance between a pure silver component and a hollow silver tube is negligible. Means as the most of the electromagnetic wave is concentrated on the outer layer, if you consider a solid silver or a hollow silver component, the performance remains to be same. So it will be very useful to reduce the cost of the material. Instead of considering a pure silver component, if you take a silver plated brass component or a hollow silver tube, the performance remains same, though, so the material cost also will be very less. Way the skin effect is very much useful in many applications related to electromagnetic waves. We can also use the skin depth to calculate the AC resistance of a conducting material due to skin effect. So now let us calculate the AC resistance of a conductor in terms of skin depth due to skin effect. Let us first calculate the DC resistance of the material. DC resistance is obtained when the frequency of operation is equal to zero. Whenever f is equal to zero, you will get the DC resistance. Or frequencies are low frequencies. So if you consider at low frequencies, the resistance offered by this material will be DC resistance. So if you consider this as the material, conducting material, now the DC resistance, the resistance offered for low frequencies are DC currents. The resistance is given by RDC is equal to rho L by A, where rho is the resistivity of the material, L is the length of the material, and A is its cross-sectional area. So if you consider the cross-sectional view of this material, which is of radius A, so this area of this cross-section is represented by A. So we have considered the radius is equal to A meters. So you can write area of cross-section is equal to pi A square. Resistivity or conductivity is related as rho is equal to 1 by sigma. Reciprocal of conductivity is resistivity. So you can write the DC resistance of this conductor is equal to RDC is equal to L by sigma pi A square. So this is the DC resistance or resistance offered by this conductor for very low frequencies or almost frequency. DC means frequency is equal to zero. Now let us calculate the AC resistance. So AC resistance, when you pass AC currents to this, it will produce varying electric field and varying magnetic field, and all the current or the fields will get concentrated only over a thickness of delta. So we use the delta skin depth in order to calculate the AC resistance of the material. So if you consider a pure conductor, the skin resistance is equal to the real part of the intrinsic impedance of the material. So you have measured the intrinsic impedance of the material as, so the intrinsic impedance of the conducting material neta is equal to 1 by sigma delta plus j by sigma delta, which we have solved before. So it is the real part of the intrinsic impedance, it is the imaginary part of the intrinsic impedance. So if you consider a pure conductor, the skin resistance is represented as RS. The skin resistance of the material will be equal to the real part of the intrinsic impedance of the material. So the real part of intrinsic impedance is 1 by sigma delta. We call this as skin resistance. Now let us define the dielectric resistance of the material. So if you consider the conductor whose radius is a meters, if you pass AC current through it, most of the fields will concentrate only over a depth of delta. We call it as skin depth. So if you want to calculate the AC resistance of this material or medium, the resistance is given by rho L by A. Rho is the resistivity of the material, L is the length of the material, and A is the area of cross section. So now here the area of cross section is the area over which the current is flowing. If you consider the area over which the current is flowing is only this much thickness of delta. So if I want to concentrate the area of cross section of this AC currents, area is equal to this area, this ring area. So you can calculate it as total area minus this area from here to here. If the total radius of this is A and this thickness is delta, from here to here the radius will be equal to A minus delta. So total area minus this area will give the area of this. So area of cross section for AC currents will be equal to pi A square, total area minus pi into this area. And this area means you have to consider only this radius, which is A minus delta whole square, which is equal to pi A square minus pi into A square plus delta square minus 2A delta, which is equal to pi A square minus pi A square minus pi delta square plus 2 pi A delta. So delta is nothing but skin depth. Skin depth will be very small. So you have observed skin depth is in the range of 10 gigahertz, you got it as 6.6 into 10 to the power minus 4. So in the range of minus 4 you have the value delta. If you take delta square, it will become even smaller. It will be approximately in the range of 10 to the power minus 8. Very much less. Delta itself is very less. Delta square will be far less. So if you multiply pi with the delta square, it will be very negligible compared to this. So you can neglect this. Means this tends to zero, almost to zero. So you will get it as 2 pi A delta. Also rho is related to conductivity as resistivity. Rho is equal to reciprocal of conductivity, 1 by sigma. So you can write RAC is equal to L divided by sigma into area. You got it as 2 pi A delta. Now you can write this as L by 2 pi A delta sigma. So this is the AC resistance offered by the material. Now if you find the ratio of AC resistance to DC resistance, you got the AC resistance is L by 2 pi A delta sigma, and previously you got DC resistance as L by pi A square into sigma. So if you solve this, you will get it as A by 2 delta. Since A is very much greater than delta, if you observe A is in meters, where delta is in millimeters, means A is very much greater than delta. Even though you take a conductor of 1 meter radius thickness, most of the fields will get concentrated over a millimeter only. Means almost the skin of the conductor, the fields will get concentrated. Means the radius of the conductor is very high compared to the skin depth of the conductor. So if you compare these two, A is very much greater than delta. Since numerator is very high compared to the denominator, you can have RAC is very much greater than RDC. So AC resistance is very high compared to the DC resistance of the conductor. If you observe, if the frequency of the electromagnetic wave increases, F increases, the skin depth will go on decrease, because skin depth is equal to 1 by root over of pi F mu sigma. So as the frequency of operation increases, skin depth decreases. If skin depth is decreasing, AC resistance will increase. So if that skin depth, if almost approaches to zero, means very thin layer, almost to zero, then the AC resistance offered by this will be equal to, if this becomes zero, the AC resistance offered by this conductor will be almost equal to infinite. So RAC tends to infinite. So we use this as an advantage for transmitting the electromagnetic wave in a waveguide. So if you see, waveguide is nothing but a hollow conducting material. So if you observe a waveguide, so a waveguide will have, it will be like a hollow tube. So if you launch electromagnetic wave of very high frequency into this hollow tube, this tube will be almost coated with silver. The layer here will be coated with silver. Since it is coated with silver, and silver is a very good conductor, the AC resistance offered by this will be very infinite. Means the skin depth is almost equal to zero, means the electromagnetic wave cannot penetrate this medium. When it hits this medium, it can't penetrate through this medium. So if energy is applied in this direction, if it does not penetrate this medium, means it should get reflected. Means as the wave is incident into this tube, it will get reflected back. Again, when it hits the other border, again it will get reflected. So in this way, total internal reflection takes place of the electromagnetic wave, and it will propagate through this tube We call this as waveguide. Now let us solve few problems related to electromagnetic wave propagation in different media. So let us consider this problem. A lossy dielectric has an intrinsic impedance of 200 angle 30 degrees ohms at a particular frequency. If at that frequency the plane wave propagating through the dielectric has the magnetic field component H bar, which is equal to 10 e power minus alpha x cos of omega t minus 1 by 2 x a y bar ampere per meter. Find electric field intensity E bar and attenuation constant alpha. Determine the skin depth. So let us write what is given to us. Given the media is lossy dielectric, means medium is lossy dielectric, and the intrinsic impedance is 200 angle 30 degrees, means intrinsic impedance neta is equal to 200 angle 30 degrees. So this is the magnitude of the intrinsic impedance, this is angle. Mod neta is equal to 200, theta neta is equal to 30 degrees. The other way of representing this is 200 angle e power j 30 degrees. Now next, if at that frequency the plane wave propagating through the dielectric has a magnetic field component, so given magnetic field component H bar is equal to 10 into e power minus alpha x cos of omega t minus half x a y bar ampere per meter. So what is given? Given the medium is lossy dielectric, intrinsic impedance neta has a magnitude 200 and angle is 30 degrees, and H bar is the magnetic field intensity. So given this, we have to determine what is the electric field intensity alpha and skin depth delta. So these three we have to find out: electric field intensity alpha and delta. So we obtained the electric field intensity and magnetic field intensity as E bar is equal to E naught e power minus alpha z cos of omega t minus beta z ax bar for a lossy dielectric medium, and H bar is equal to E naught by mod neta e power minus alpha z cos of omega t minus beta z minus theta neta a y bar. So given we got, because we have assumed the electric field has components along x direction, and we got the corresponding magnetic field components along y direction, if we consider the wave is propagating along z direction. So since we have assumed the wave is propagating along z direction, it is a function of z and the components are along x. But if you observe the given magnetic field, the magnetic field is a function of x, means the wave is propagating along x direction, and magnetic field components are along y direction. So the magnetic field has components along y direction, but the wave is propagating along x direction, because the magnetic field is varying as a function of x, means the wave is propagating along x direction. So you can write the direction of wave propagation ak bar is equal to ax bar, because variation is seen along x direction. For the assumption we made for deriving the expressions for electric field and magnetic field for lossless dielectric, we got this, means it is varying along z direction. But here, given it is a function of x, means the wave is varying along x direction, and h bar has a components along y direction, means a h bar, means direction of the magnetic field is along a y bar. So in order to obtain in which direction the electric field is oriented, you have the relation: if electric field is oriented in a e bar direction, a e bar cross a h bar will give the direction of wave propagation a k bar. So we don't know what is a e bar, so a e bar cross a h bar is equal to a y bar, which is equal to a k bar. We already know it is a x bar. So if you know the cross product a x a y a z, a x cross a y will be equal to a z, a y cross a z will give a x bar, a z cross a x will give a y bar. So the answer should be a x bar. If the answer should be a x bar, it should be a y cross a z. But here we have a reverse, means a x bar you should obtain it as, so if you do a z bar cross a y bar, a z bar cross a y bar, if a y bar cross a z bar is a x bar, then a z bar cross a y bar will be equal to minus a x bar. But the answer should be a x bar, means a e bar must be equal to minus a z bar. Now if you do minus a z bar cross a y bar, you will get it as minus half a z bar cross a y bar is equal to minus a x bar. So minus of minus, you will get it as a. So the direction of the electric field, means the component of the electric field, lie along minus a z bar direction. So now in the expression for electric field, you got the direction of electromagnetic wave and the electric field intensity. Now we have to obtain what is E naught, what is alpha, and what is beta. So if you observe the H bar has H naught is equal to 10. H naught, from this you can write H naught is equal to 10. Alpha is not there. Cos of omega t minus beta z, in place of beta you have half, means beta is equal to half, and it is oriented along y direction, it has components along y direction. Now you know H naught, beta, direction of electromagnetic wave propagation. So in order to obtain E bar, I want what is E naught, what is alpha. So I already got the direction. So now I have to determine what is E naught and what is alpha. How to obtain E naught? You have the relation between E naught by H naught as neta is equal to E naught by H naught. H naught is equal to 10, then E naught is equal to 10 into neta. So neta is equal to 200 angle 30 degrees. So 10 into 200 angle 30 degrees means 2000 angle 30 degrees. This can also be written as 2000 angle e power j 30 degrees. So you got E naught. Now let us determine what is alpha. Given beta, we have to determine alpha. For which medium? Lossy dielectric medium. For a lossy dielectric medium, alpha is given by omega root over of mu epsilon divided by 2 into root over of 1 plus sigma by omega epsilon whole square minus 1. And beta is equal to omega root over of mu epsilon divided by 2 into root over of 1 plus sigma by omega epsilon whole square plus 1. So already beta is equal to half, we know. Now we have to determine what is alpha. To determine alpha, they didn't give omega value, mu value, epsilon value, nothing they have given. But we should obtain what is alpha. So what we will do here is, we will find the ratio between alpha and beta. If you find the ratio between alpha and beta, alpha divided by beta, you will get it as omega root over of mu epsilon by 2 into root of 1 plus sigma by omega epsilon whole square minus 1 divided by omega root mu epsilon divided by 2 root over of 1 plus sigma by omega epsilon whole square plus 1. So omega will get cancelled out. So you'll get overall root of mu epsilon by 2, denominator also you'll get mu epsilon by 2, they do get cancelled. So overall root over of 1 plus sigma by omega epsilon whole square minus 1 divided by root over of 1 plus sigma by omega epsilon whole square plus 1. So this is equal to alpha by beta. Now we should know what is sigma by omega epsilon. You already know that the angle of intrinsic impedance is equal to 30 degrees they have given. In the problem they have given angle of intrinsic impedance equal to 30 degrees. You know the relation between theta and theta neta. Theta is equal to 2 theta neta. But theta is equal to what? Tan inverse sigma by omega epsilon. Or tan theta is equal to sigma by omega epsilon. Which is nothing but loss tangent. So theta can be obtained from theta neta. So theta neta equal to 30 degrees means theta must be equal to 60 degrees. 2 into 30 will give 60 degrees. Tan 30 will be equal to sigma by omega epsilon. So in place of sigma by omega epsilon, you have to substitute tan 30, tan 60, theta equal to 60 degrees. So tan 60 degrees is equal to sigma by omega epsilon. Tan 60 degrees is equal to root 3. So you'll have sigma by omega epsilon is equal to root 3. So substitute in this, you will get it as root over of 1 plus root 3 whole square. Sigma by omega epsilon is root 3 whole square minus 1 divided by root over of 1 plus root 3 whole square plus 1. Root 3 whole square is 3, 3 plus 1 4, 4 under root is 2. So here you will get 2 minus 1 divided by overall root 2 plus 1. 2 minus 1, 1 divided by 2 plus 1, 3 means you will get it as 1 by root 3 is equal to alpha by beta. So alpha by beta is equal to 1 by root 3, but beta is equal to half. So alpha is equal to 1 by root 3 into beta, but beta you already know it is half into 1 by 2, which is equal to 1 by 2 root. So now you got the value of alpha. So alpha is equal to 1 by 2 root 3. This is one solution. Now let us determine what is E bar. E bar is can be written as real part of ES bar into e power j omega t, where ES bar is nothing but E naught e power minus gamma. If the wave is propagating along z direction, you used to write it as minus gamma z. Now the wave is propagating along x direction. So you should write it as minus alpha x into e power j omega t. So which is equal to real part of. So E naught E naught is equal to 2000 angle e power j 30 degrees. Now we will substitute in that expression. E naught is equal to 2000 angle e power j 30 degrees into e power minus gamma x can be written as minus of gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta. So we will get minus alpha x into e power minus j beta x into e power j omega t. This can be further simplified. E naught 2000 e power minus alpha x e power, if you take j common, you will get omega t minus beta x minus 30 degrees. So it is E naught minus gamma x. ES bar is equal to E naught e power minus gamma x, because the wave is propagating along x direction, so it will vary as a function of x. And the direction is given by, you already derived the electric field is directed along minus az bar direction. So add az bar, the direction to it. It is equal to, so you can write this as 2000 minus az bar. So you can bring minus here, minus 2000 e power minus alpha x. Real part of this quantity is cos of omega t minus beta x minus 30 degrees into az bar. So this is the electric field for the given question. So we got alpha and we got electric field intensity e bar. So now the third question is, what is skin depth delta? Skin depth delta is equal to 1 by alpha. You already know what is alpha. 1 by alpha will be equal to 2 root 3. So skin depth delta is equal to 2 root 3. So for the given question, we determine what is alpha, what is electric field intensity, what is the skin depth. So hence we obtain what is electric field, what is alpha, and what is skin depth. we have done a small mistake while deriving this. You got E bar is equal to alpha 2000 e power j 30 degrees, means plus j 30 degrees. So when you take j common, you will get omega t minus beta x plus 30 degrees. So do this change. So instead of minus 30 degrees, you will get it as plus 30 degrees. So these are the final answers, alpha, e bar and delta.